crews aboard the International Space Station are continuing their cutting-edge science and technology research benefiting people living on our home planet. To ensure their crucial work continues uninterrupted, NASA at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida is preparing to launch a Cygnus spacecraft to supply the orbiting outpost. The space station serves as the world's leading laboratory where astronauts perform studies that will enable human and robotic exploration of destinations beyond low Earth orbit, including an asteroid and Mars. The upcoming launch of Orbital ATK's Cygnus spacecraft will be the company's fifth mission under NASA's Commercial Resupply Services contract to keep work going aboard the station. Cygnus will carry about 7,700 pounds of supplies and vehicle hardware to the station to support the work of the Expedition 47 and 48 crews. Orbital ATK's Dan Pani is familiar with the work taking place aboard the International Space Station. He's a former NASA astronaut who spent 120 days in space during Expedition 16 from October 2007 to February 2008. He recently spoke about what it's like when a cargo vessel arrives with needed supplies and equipment.
It's like Christmas, right? Open a big box of goodies and finding some stuff that you've been wanting and finding some surprises that you didn't know about.
Cygnus will lift off atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket from Space Launch Complex 41 at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. Speaking in Kennedy's Payload Hazardous Servicing Facility, where Cygnus was undergoing final preparations, Pani described how the unpiloted spacecraft will go to work after liftoff as it travels autonomously to its destination.
Biggest moments for me are getting onto orbit, getting the vehicle all configured so it can fly and perform in orbit correctly, and then making its approach to the space station.
As Cygnus approaches the space station, the astronauts begin their vital role to capture or grapple the cargo-laden spacecraft.
The crew on board gets involved about 2 hours before they actually grapple it, and their job is to watch the vehicle as it's coming in. As we progress up to the exact place where they will grapple it, the arm will be in place, and they will then command the arm and go in to grapple the Cygnus.
For this mission, the Cygnus will deliver many important items, including the second generation of a portable device to demonstrate 3D printing on the space station. Also aboard will be an instrument for the first space-based observations of the chemical composition of meteors entering Earth's atmosphere. Another experiment will involve igniting and studying a large-scale fire inside an empty Cygnus resupply vehicle after it leaves the space station and prior to its re-entering the Earth's atmosphere. The goal is to improve understanding of how a fire grows in microgravity in order to safeguard future space missions. These experiments and many others aboard the International Space Station continue ongoing efforts working off the Earth for the Earth.